In today's lecture, we are going to see a new chapter from CHP 4101 paper. And today's topic is quantum chemistry. So in quantum chemistry syllabus, there are several points given as a historical development of quantum theory. Next point is failure of classical mechanics. Third point is black body radiation. Next one is photoelectric effect, atomic spectrum, wave particle duality principle, Heisenberg uncertainty principle, then Schrodinger equation for particle in 1D box and for hydrogen like atoms. Then the postulates, then HMOT of ethylene, propylene, butadiene and the cyclobutadiene. So these are the points included in our syllabus of the quantum chemistry. So we will start with first historical development of the quantum mechanics. So definition of the quantum mechanics is, the quantum mechanics is a branch of science which deals with atomic and the molecular properties and the behavior of matter on a microscopic scale. So simply, quantum mechanics is a branch of the science which deals with atomic and the molecular properties and the behavior of matter based on the microscopic scale. It is not useful for the macro molecules, it is useful for the micro. Then here is the introduction of the quantum mechanics. So there are a few phenomena which the classical mechanics failed to explain. So classical mechanics was given by the Isaac Newton in the 17th century. And the quantum mechanics came in 19th century, and this was developed by Max Planck at a meeting of German Physical Society. Read his paper on the theory of the energy distribution law of normal spectrum, and this was the start of the revolution of the physics or the quantum mechanics. So from that the quantum mechanics were start. So the several phenomena are there which cannot be proven by the classical mechanics, such as the stability of an atom, then spectral series of hydrogen atom and the black body radiation. So these phenomena cannot be explained by the classical mechanics, and these are in detail explained by the quantum mechanics, which was developed by the Max Planck in 19th century. Then the quantum mechanics, it is a generalization of classical physics that includes the classical laws as a special cases, which was developed by the Newton. The quantum physics extends that the range to the region of small dimensions. That means the microscopic properties we can learn in the quantum chemistry or the quantum mechanics or the quantum physics. Just as the c is the velocity of light, which signifies a universal constant, is the small c, and the Planck's constant characterizes the quantum physics. So it gives the value of h, which is a Planck's constant. H is equal to 6.65 × 10⁻²⁷ ergs second. Or the value which we know very well is the H is equal to 6.625 × 10⁻³⁴ joules second. So this is the value of the Planck's constant. Again, it was found by the Max Planck. Then the quantum mechanics is able to explain the various concepts like the photoelectric effect, black body radiation, Compton effect and the emission of line spectra, that is the hydrogen spectrum. The most outstanding development in the modern science was the conception of a quantum mechanics, which was developed in 19th century. And in the modern science, it was developed in 1925, which is a quantum mechanics. And this new approach was highly successful in explaining about the behavior of atoms, molecules and nuclei. So we cannot also with the naked eye, this atoms, molecules, nuclei or the lines in the emission or the absorption spectrums. So these are the microscopic properties and which can be studied in the quantum mechanics. Now there are the applications of the quantum mechanics in the chemistry. So these are the quantum chemistry applications. So quantum chemistry applies quantum mechanics to solve the problems in the chemistry. So here are, as we know, several branches of the chemistry are there, like the physical, organic, inorganic and so on. So we will see only three. So physical chemists use the quantum mechanics to interpret molecular spectrums, thereby allowing experimental determination of the molecular properties such as bonds, bond lengths, bond angles, dipole moments, etc. can be determined by using the quantum mechanics. Because it works on the molecular level, microscopic level, then the quantum mechanics can be applied to estimate the transition states. Then it is useful for estimation of the rate constants. So these are the applications of the quantum mechanics in the physical chemistry. Now we will see the applications in the organic chemistry. So organic chemists use the quantum mechanics to estimate the relative stabilities of the molecules, then to investigate the mechanisms of the chemical reactions and then transition states again. Then organic chemists use quantum mechanics to predict the aromaticity of the compound. So these are the applications of the quantum mechanics in the organic chemistry. And now the inorganic chemist uses quantum mechanics to predict and explain the properties of the transition metal complexes or the complex ion by using the ligand field theory. An appropriate or the approximate quantum mechanical method is useful for finding the complex formed or not, or it can be useful for finding the properties of the transition metal complexes. Then here is the next point of today's discussion is failures of the classical mechanics. So in the late 17th century, Isaac Newton discovered the classical mechanics. The laws of motion, as we know, there are three laws of motion and which are useful for the macroscopic objects. So Newton's laws were successful at explaining the motion of planets and everyday objects such as a pendulum, projectiles, etc. So classical mechanics, which is failed when it was applied to very small particles such as bond, atoms, nuclei, electrons and the energy levels. In the last quarter of the 19th century, various experimental observations were obtained, like the black body radiations, photoelectric effect, that could not be explained by the classical mechanics, which was developed by Isaac Newton. And this results led to the development of the quantum theory. So the quantum mechanics came. So simply quantum mechanics, as we have discussed, it is a branch of science which deals with the atomic and the molecular properties and the behavior of matter on a microscopic scale. So simply classical mechanics is useful for the macroscopic objects and the quantum mechanics is applied to the microscopic objects, and it explains very well the photoelectric effect and black body radiation and so many concepts. So atomic spectra are defined as the spectrum of the electromagnetic radiation either emitted or absorbed by an electron during the transitions between different energy levels within an atom. As we know, there is absorption spectra and the emission spectra. When the ground state atom or the electron or the molecule absorbs energy, it goes to the excited state and then again comes to the ground state with the emission of the some amount of energy. So that will be either atomic spectrum, and this is due to either emission or the absorption. So when an electron gets excited from one energy level to another, it either emits or absorbs light of a specific wavelength. And here is the atomic spectrum. So, atomic spectrum in which several regions are there, like a gamma rays, X-rays, ultraviolet radiations, UV visible radiations, infrared radiation, microwaves and the radio frequency radiation. So, first region is the gamma radiation region. Second is the X-ray. Third one is ultraviolet. Then our visible region, that is a 400 to 800 nanometer region. And next is the IR, then microwaves and the radio frequency region. So these are the various regions of the energy spectrum. So as we see, from left to right, the wavelength is going to increase and it is given in the meters. Then the frequency, which from left to right, frequency goes on increasing. Or from right to left, frequency goes on increasing, or left to right, it is going to decrease. Then as we know, the energy equation E is equal to H nu. Nu is the frequency which is given by C upon lambda. Lambda is the wavelength. And due to limited lifetime of the excited state, the transitions to a state of lower energy occurs and light gets emitted. And it was observed that for a wide range of frequencies, light is observed only at a certain discrete frequencies, that is quantized, and are called as a line spectrum. So in these all regions, we will get a spectrum in the ultraviolet region, invisible region, in infrared region, microwave region, and the radio frequency region. We can study the different parameters. Like in ultraviolet region, we will study the electron transition. In again visible region, we will see electron transitions from valence shell. Then in IR, we will see vibrational motions, microwave, rotational motion, and the radio frequency, it will be the NMR. So simply these are the regions, and we will see the various type of motions of the electrons or the molecules. So we will get a line spectrum, and the position of the spectral lines in terms of wave number in hydrogen spectrum, which is given by the Rydberg equation. Mu bar in per centimeter is equal to R. R is the Rydberg constant, which is in per centimeter, into 1 upon N1 square minus 1 upon N square. Here N is larger than N1. And this is the atomic spectrum of the hydrogen for the Balmer series. So simply the H alpha, H beta, H gamma and H delta are given, and there are various values of the wavelength are given. These are for red light, blue, green light, blue or violet light. So simply Rydberg formula uses or relates the energy difference between the various levels of Bohr's model and the wavelengths of the absorbed or emitted photons. So simply, energy difference can be found, and it is mathematically expressed as 1 upon lambda. Simply 1 upon lambda, you can write it as a wave number mu bar, is equal to R into Z square, in a bracket 1 upon NL square minus 1 upon NH square. Here NL is the lower energy level and H is the higher energy level, and NH is greater than NL. Z is the atomic number for hydrogen, it is 1, so you can simply write the equation R into 1 upon NL square minus 1 upon NA square, or this equation can be written as in a simpler form with this equation. And R is the Rydberg constant in meter inverse, the value is given here, and in the centimeter inverse value is 10906777.76 centimeter inverse. This is the value of the Rydberg constant R. Lambda is the wavelength. So instead of this, you can write equation this. Mu bar is equal to R into 1 upon N1 square minus 1 upon N2 or N square. And here the various series are given. Lyman series N1 is 1 and N values are given 2, 3, 4, 5. And this is the spectral region in the ultraviolet region. Then the Balmer, where N1 is equal to 2 and N is equal to 3, 4, 5. Each time one number is higher for N. Then this is observed in the visible region. Then the Passion is the third series, where N1 is equal to 3 and N is equal to 4, 5, 6. Then bracket here, N1 is equal to 4 and N is equal to 5, 6, 7, which is observed in the IR region. And last one is the P fund series, where N1 is equal to 5 and N is equal to 6, 7, 8, which is observed in again IR region. Now here is one problem is given, which is based on this series. So calculate the wave number, wavelength and the frequency of the first line in the Lyman series. So first line is given in the Lyman series. So for Lyman series, as we know, N1 is equal to 1 from this. N1 is equal to 1. And the for first line is given. So N is given here 2. So N is equal to 2 and N1 is equal to 1. Just put the values. Mu bar is equal to R in bracket 1 upon N1 square minus 1 upon N square. So N1 is equal to 1 and small n is equal to 2. And R value is 109677.76. So from that we can firstly found the mu bar 82257.32 per centimeter. So this is the value of the wave number. From that we are going to calculate the value of lambda. So lambda is equal to 1 upon wave number. So it's equal to 1.215 into 10 raised to minus 5 centimeter, that is 1215 angstrom unit. And now we are going to find out the frequency. So frequency is equal to C upon lambda. Put all the values. It will come 2.467 into 10 raised to plus 15 per second. So you can solve such type of problems by yourself and try to solve the problems based on all the series.